Hello everyone, today is Sunday, January 21st, 2018. This article from Activist Post. YouTube just moved to crush the little people will only monetize large accounts. YouTube alienated a large portion of its audience this week by demonetizing all of their smaller content creators. In an email sent out to millions of independent artists, musicians, and journalists, YouTube informed them that they were no longer eligible for advertising revenue on the site because their channels were simply not big enough. The site now requires a minimum of 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of viewed content, automatically disqualifying a large chunk of their creators from monetization. Below is an email that the company sent out to up-and-coming YouTubers. These higher standards will help us prevent potentially inappropriate videos from monetizing, which can hurt revenue for everyone. Though these changes will affect a significant number of channels, 99% of those effective were making less than $100 per year in the last year, with 90% earning less than $2.50 in the last month. Any of the channels who no longer meet this threshold will be paid what they've already earned based on our AdSense policies. After thoughtful consideration, we believe these are necessary compromises to protect our community. Really? Under the new eligibility requirements announced today, your YouTube channel, blank, is no longer eligible for monetization because it doesn't meet the new threshold of 4,000 hours of watch time within the past 12 months and 1,000 subscribers. As a result, your channel will lose access to all monetization tools and features associated with the YouTube Partner Program on February 20th, 2018, unless you surpass this threshold in the next 30 days. Accordingly, this email serves as 30-day notice that your YouTube Partner Program terms are terminated. One of YouTube's core values is to provide anyone the opportunity to earn money from a thriving channel. Well, how do they determine what a thriving channel is? That is such a vague definition, just like their community guideline strikes are vague. Creators who haven't yet reached this new threshold can continue to benefit from our Creator Academy, our help center, and all the resources on the creator's site to grow their channels. Once your channel reaches the new threshold, it will be reviewed to make sure it adheres to our policies and guidelines, and if so, monetization will be re-enabled. The company also said that the change in policy was intended to, quote, prevent bad actors from harming the inspiring and original creators around the world who make their living on YouTube. What a bunch of crap. How do they determine bad actors and bad musicians and bad artists and bad channels? This is just another example of censorship. However, the article continues, having a small channel does not make someone a bad actor. In fact, some of the worst and most inappropriate content has come from the whales of YouTube, not the little fish. It is also important to mention that with this new policy, if a smaller channel has a video go viral overnight and suddenly reaches the threshold, they may not be able to monetize this potentially once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. This certainly ends up helping YouTube and hurting independent media, but this should be expected. This article continues to go on and talk about YouTube and the things that they're doing. Oh my gosh, this article makes me sick. I don't monetize my channel, but there are people who do and rely on that money, and they're relying on getting those videos circulated. And even these number counts that are on some of these videos aren't even right. Some of these number counts don't even make any sense. So once again, YouTube is just crushing the little people and censoring these channels and these important videos. Have a great day, everyone.